Thank you, Madam President. Madam President, I wanted to just take a few minutes to talk about today, which is Texas Independence Day. And on this day in 1836, delegates from 59 Texas settlements signed a declaration of their right to live in liberty and to take charge of their own destiny. The document they produced shares much in common with the declaration signed in Philadelphia six decades earlier. For example, in both sets, the founders believed in fundamental human rights, including the right to address government for grievances. Both groups of founders insisted on the obligation to change the form of government if it trampled on those rights. Both founders created new nations and have been honored by successive generations for creating legacies of liberty. Of course, there were differences between the conventions in 1776 and 1836 between Philadelphia and Washington on the Brazos. For one thing, Texans took action quickly. They adopted their declaration on the second day of their convention. They acted quickly because they knew the forces of tyranny were already in the field, and at that moment were trying to crush their freedoms. Less than 200 miles to the west, Santa Ana's army was laying siege to the Alamo. Its young commander, William Barrett Travis, had sent out an inspiring letter just days earlier. In it, he wrote, "Fellow citizens and compatriots, I am besieged by 1,000 or more of the Mexicans under Santa Ana. The enemy has demanded a surrender. Otherwise, the garrison are to be put to the sword. I've answered the demand with a cannon shot, and our flag still waves proudly from the walls. I shall never surrender or retreat." Well, history tells us that death came to the defenders of the Alamo, but soon victory came to the people of Texas. On April 21st of that year, Sam Houston and about 900 Texas soldiers defeated the much larger Mexican army at the Battle of San Jacinto. By this victory, Texans won the independence they had declared less than 2 months earlier. Now, Sam Houston, the commander of those troops and the commander-in-chief of the troops at the Battle of San Jacinto, had served as a congressman from Tennessee. He served as governor of Tennessee, and after the Battle of San Jacinto, went on to be elected president of the Republic of Texas and then become one of the first Texans to serve in the United States Senate in the seat that I currently occupy. And I believe that he and other founders of our republic and now of our great state would be proud of the 24 million Americans who call Texas home. They'd be proud that Texas remains a land of opportunity and that we're outperforming the nation in job creation. They'd be proud of the fact that Texas remains a welcoming state for pioneers of all stripes, and we've led the nation in population growth over the last 2 years as people have voted with their feet and moved to the land of opportunity, otherwise known as Texas. They'd be proud that even during a severe recession, we continue to build businesses and raise families and make our communities even better places to live. Just like the founding generation, we're showing the world that when faced with adversity, Texans do not retreat, we reload. Madam President, in honor of the founders of the Republic of Texas and all who are free because of their vision and sacrifice, I say God bless Texas and may God bless the United States of America. Madam President, I yield the floor.